Welcome back, students. Now I am going to continue the topic with conversion of NFA with epsilon mos to without epsilon mos. Before going to that point, we will discuss about what you mean by epsilon closure, how we are going to find the epsilon closure of each and every state which is present in the NFA. In NFA with epsilon mos, here we are going to process the empty string. Is it right? In this case, we have to check for each and every state which is present in that particular NFA, is that particular state is going to be processed by that epsilon mo or not. We have to check first. That checking is known as epsilon closure of that particular state. Here NFA with epsilon mos is consisting of 5 tuples Q, sigma, delta, Q naught and F. Q is the set of states, sigma is the set of input alpha states, delta is the mapping function, Q cross sigma cross epsilon into 2 power Q, Q naught is the initial state, F is the set of final states, right? Now, whenever we are going to convert this NFA with epsilon mos to without epsilon mos, first we have to find the epsilon closure for each and every state which is present in that particular NFA with epsilon mos. Here epsilon closure means, here we have to define the epsilon closure to define the extended transition function for the epsilon NFA. Right? Here in that particular case, how we are going to defining the extended transition function for this one. See here, for example, one state is there. State is having Q state is there. To find the epsilon closure for any state Q, that particular Q itself include in that epsilon closure state. Q itself present in that epsilon closure of that particular state. And if P is in epsilon closure of Q, then all the states accessible from P through path of epsilon are also included in epsilon closure, present in epsilon closure. Whenever we are going to reach any state by using the epsilon mos, that particular states are going to be present in the epsilon closure of that particular state. Here in this example, see here, I'll show one example. See here, this is the example of NFA, right? NFA with epsilon mos. Here I am having how many states here? Q naught, Q1 and Q2. Which one is the initial state here? Q0 is the initial state. Which one is the final state? Q2 is the final state, right? Here initial state is going to be indicated by this arrow mark. Final state is going to be indicated by this Q2, right? Now, here Q0, Q1, Q2, three states are there. 0, 1 and one more input symbol is there, that is epsilon. Now, Q0 on 0, is there any possibility? Is there Q0 on 0? No. So we have to find pi. Q naught on 1, Q naught. Q naught on epsilon. So here we are going to reach Q1. We can reach Q1, right? Q1 on 0, Q1. Q1 on 1. Q1 on 1. Is there Q1 on 1 is there? No, Q1 is 1. Q1 on 1 is not there. Q1 on epsilon, we can reach Q2. Right? Now, Q2 on 0, Q2. Q2 on 1, Q2. Q2 on epsilon, no other state is there. Now, here, epsilon move is different and epsilon closure is different. See here, epsilon move is here. If we are going to process that particular input string, if that particular string, empty string on that particular state, if any state changes occur, then that particular move is known as the epsilon move, right? See here, Q0 on 0, Q0 on 0. Is there any move is there? Q naught on 0, null is there. Here, we are not going to process the epsilon closure on input symbols. We are going to process the epsilon closures on states. Here, in this case, how many states are there? Q naught, Q1, Q2 states are there. Here also, so I have to find the epsilon closure for Q1, epsilon closure for Q2. I am not going to process for that input string. I am not going to process for the input string. See here. Here, whenever we are going to find the epsilon closure, that particular state is going to present in that particular epsilon closure. See here, I am finding on Q0, so Q0 is present here. Right? Here, from Q0, how many states we are going to travel? Here, Q0, from here, Q0 and epsilon, we can reach Q1, right? So, this is Q1. See here, from Q0, is there any possibility? Is there we can change this state? See here, this is also the epsilon. This is also the epsilon move, right? This is also the epsilon move. So we can reach up to Q2 state by using this empty string. We can reach the Q2 state by using this empty string. So Q2. Right. Now. This is the epsilon closure. How we can reach up to that particular string? Q0, Q0, Q1, Q2. Now Q1, here epsilon closure of Q1. Epsilon closure of Q1 means here Q1 state, that is Q1. Is there any possibility is there to reach Q2? Yes. Q2 state. We can reach by Q2 state. Right. Is there any possibility is there by using this one? Reaching of Q0? No. Epsilon closure of Q2. Epsilon closure of Q2. Q2 state itself. Is there any possibility is there by using the Q2 reaching of Q1 and Q0? No. This is the finding of epsilon closure for the given set of states which are present in NFA with epsilon moves. NFA with epsilon moves, right? Now, my next topic is we are going to convert this NFA with epsilon moves to without epsilon moves. NFA with epsilon moves to without epsilon moves. In that particular case here, first step is we have to find the epsilon closures. We have to find the epsilon closure for each and every states which are present in that particular NFA with epsilon move. First step. Next step is we have to find the extended transition function. We have to find the extended transition function. Here, extended transition function is going to indicated by with the delta cap. Extended transition function is going to indicated by this delta cap. Here, first, delta cap of Q0, epsilon. Delta cap of Q0, epsilon is epsilon closure of Q0, epsilon closure of Q0. Next is delta cap of Q0, A is epsilon closure of delta cap of Q0, epsilon, A. So, this is the second step is very, very important. Second step is very, very important here. Then in step 3, we are going to find the all this set of final state. We are going to find the all this set of final states, right? In first step, we are going to find the epsilon closure of all these states. Next is we have to find the extended transition function, that is the delta cap. Delta cap of Q0, epsilon is epsilon closure of Q0. Next, delta cap of Q0, A is epsilon closure of delta cap of Q0, epsilon, A. Then is we have to set the final state, which is consisting of all the final states which are present in NFA, right? Now, I'll take one example. See here, this is my NFA with epsilon moves. NFA with epsilon moves. This NFA is consisting of A, B, C, D, E states, and my input symbols are 0, 1, epsilon, 0, 1, epsilon. Now, here my first step is I have to find the epsilon closure here. Already this transition table has been given. You have to draw the transition graph. You have to draw the transition diagram. Then in step 1, I have to find the epsilon closure. I have to find the epsilon closure for this one, right? Epsilon closure. Sorry. epsilon closure of A. What is the epsilon closure of A? That particular state itself. Is there any move is there? There is no move is there for epsilon move. So we have to stop. Next. Next is epsilon closure of B. Epsilon closure of B. That particular state B itself and here E is there. So B comma E. Next. Epsilon closure of C. Epsilon closure of C. What is epsilon closure of C? C itself. Any other move is there? No. Other move is not there. Next. Epsilon closure of D. D comma E. Right. Next is epsilon closure of E. Epsilon closure of E. That particular state itself E. Right. This is the step one. In step one, we are going to find the epsilon closure of each and every state which is present in that particular NFA. In next step, we are going to find the extended transition function. What is the extended transition function? That is the delta cap. First, delta cap of here. What we have to do first? Delta cap of C here. Delta cap of Q naught comma epsilon. So delta cap of Q naught comma epsilon means A comma epsilon. Delta cap of Q comma A comma epsilon. It is equivalent of here. See the formula here. Epsilon closure of Q naught. Epsilon closure of Q naught. So epsilon closure of A. Epsilon closure of A. What is the epsilon closure of A? What is the epsilon closure of A here? Epsilon closure of A is A. Epsilon closure of A is A. Next, we have to find the delta cap of A comma 0. Delta cap of A comma 0. Delta cap of A comma 0 means here. See here. Epsilon closure of. Here we have to write epsilon closure of C here. Delta cap of same formula. Q naught comma epsilon. Q naught. See, Q naught means A comma epsilon comma here. Here A is there na. Here is also A is there. We have to process that particular string. Here 0 is there. So 0. Right. Here delta cap of A naught comma 0 is equivalent of epsilon closure. Delta cap of A comma epsilon comma 0. Then it is equivalent of epsilon closure delta cap of A comma epsilon, that is A, delta of A comma, here what is this one here, value of this one is, I'll use this pencil, value of delta cap of A comma epsilon is A, so A, we have to process this string 0, so I'm using this 0, right, now, equivalent of epsilon closure of delta of A comma 0. Delta of A comma 0 is B. Delta of A comma 0 is B. Epsilon closure of B is B comma E. Epsilon closure of B is B comma E. B comma E. Right. Next is we have to find the delta cap of A comma 0 1. This is the extension function for 0 comma 1, right? Here, this is equivalent of epsilon closure of delta cap of a comma 0 comma 1, right? Here first a of 0, already we find a of 0, right? Equivalence of epsilon closure delta of, what is the value of delta cap of a comma 0? Delta cap of a comma 0 is b comma e. Delta cap of a comma 0 is b comma e, right? b comma e comma 1, right? Now it is equivalent of epsilon closure of delta b comma 1 union delta of e comma 1, delta of b comma 1 comma delta of e comma 1. So it is equivalent of, what is epsilon closure of delta of b comma 1? B comma 1 is d union e comma 1 is e, right? So it is equivalent of epsilon closure of d union epsilon closure of e. Epsilon closure of d and epsilon closure of e. What is the epsilon closure of d? D comma e. D comma e union e. It is equivalent of d comma e. It is equivalent of d comma e. Now you have to find delta cap of b comma 0, then delta cap of b comma 0 comma 1, then we have to find each and everything, right? Delta cap of here, delta cap of b comma epsilon, b delta cap of b comma 0, delta cap of b comma 0 1, then delta cap of c comma epsilon, then delta cap of c comma epsilon comma 0, then delta cap of c comma 0 comma 1, then d comma epsilon, d comma 0, d comma 0 1, then e comma epsilon, e comma 0, and e comma 0 1. You have to process, then after that you have to write this transition diagram. See here. Up to here clear na? For this A, you are getting here. I am going to write here. For this A, you are getting here. Just for the indicating here, I am writing here. For A, I am getting B comma E. One is D comma E. For this A, right? Now, I am going to write for this one. Now I'm going to write this one, delta cap of, see here, for this one, delta cap of b comma epsilon. What is delta cap of b comma epsilon? Epsilon closure of b. That is epsilon closure of B. What is the epsilon closure of B? That is BE. Right. Next is, I have to find delta cap of B comma 0. That is epsilon closure of delta of epsilon closure of delta of delta of delta cap of delta of delta cap of b comma epsilon comma 0. B comma epsilon comma 0. It is equivalent of epsilon closure, that is delta comma b comma e, b comma epsilon is b comma e, delta of b comma e comma 0, right? Next is epsilon closure of delta b comma 0 union delta of e comma 0. Delta of b comma 0 equivalent of epsilon closure of delta of b comma 0 is pi, right? E comma 0 is E. So this is epsilon closure of E. What is the epsilon closure of E? That is E, right? Next is you have to find the delta cap of b comma 0 1. So epsilon closure of delta of delta cap of b comma 0 comma 1, right? B comma 0 comma 1. Epsilon closure of delta b comma 0 is E. Delta of E comma 1, right? Next is epsilon closure of E. Epsilon closure of E is E only, right? This is B. Next you have to find delta cap of C comma 0, delta cap of C comma 0 1. Next you have to find delta cap of D comma 0, delta cap of D comma 0 1. Next you have to find delta cap of E comma 0, delta cap of E comma 0 1. You have to find, then you have to draw the transition diagram for that one. This is the conversion of NFA with epsilon moves to without epsilon moves. Here this is the homework. You have to complete it, right? Thank you.